one of the first shows that I started to review is back, and all I have to say is, it's about time. All right, I promise, don't go anywhere. The rest of my review will be slightly more insightful than that. Time travel in general has been a big passion of mine, and a disproportionate amount of the shows that I watch involve time travel for one reason or another. So, tonight, when we're back, I can't wait to see what happens with Timeless.
Welcome to the heart of the stories we tell. My name is Rob, and tonight I will be reviewing...
Timeless, Season 2, Episode 1, The War to End All Wars. I'll be honest with you, I wasn't holding out a lot of hope for this show, even though I loved it. I knew a lot of people didn't, and time travel's a hard concept to sell in this day and age. The show was canceled, but then the fans brought it back, so woohoo! Big thank you to all of us! It's far from the first show that's ever had this happen, and it won't be the last. But alright, there's a lot going on with time mechanics. If you want to see some of my older videos talking about it, we can, but this episode looks to be complicated. I don't even fully remember everything that happened last year. And part of me says that the war, the end all wars, is World War I, but it could be a time war, too. Maybe double duty. Alright, for those of you that don't know, what I do here is I review stories as they come out, do Throwback Thursdays every Thursday, almost every Thursday, and then every Sunday I take apart a story and try to figure out how and why we tell them. If that sounds interesting, click subscribe, because we are going to jump headlong into the heart of Timeless, as things have changed this season. The idea of what the enemy is has changed. Now, this show is already historically littered with great concepts, great characters, great people that were realistic people. We've already examined so much of history that I honestly feel like this show should be getting an award just for teaching people the few things that it does. But it also has some weird time travel rules, and let's be honest, the Rittenhouse mystery was a big selling point. Before we talk about tonight's episode, let me just throw this up there.
So once again, it's stop. Spoiler time.
So Lucy's been taken by Rittenhouse and recruited to run part of their time travel shenanigans with her mother. But at the same time, they believe they've killed Wyatt and Rufus, who have really been moved to an off-site location by the CIA and are currently trying to get the lifeboat back up and running to rescue her. Meanwhile, remember last year, Flynn got arrested. And remember, Flynn was the main villain last year. But then we found out, twist, he's fighting this group called Rittenhouse. And this group called Rittenhouse is pretty effed up and are pretty messed up. So, he now isn't so much the villain as a bad person who was trying to stop worse bad people. I think I need to rewrite that sentence. Wyatt's going nuts and stir crazy because he's trying to figure out what happened to Lucy and where she is. Or, well, when she is. But at the same time, Lucy's going a little nuts herself, having to be part of Rittenhouse. And on top of that, we have Rufus trying to rebuild the time machine, with Mason, who doesn't fully understand the technology even though he invented it, and his girlfriend, who, remember, is having headaches that induced visions of previous timelines. Got all that? That's our wrap-up. But okay, this episode starts with Rittenhouse having upped its game. They've got agents hidden throughout time, already having advanced technology and understanding, and all of a sudden I'm wondering when the gonna-jump-forward episode is. But okay, and they've messed up the time stream royally last year, and this year they're already off to a banger of a start, as they're trying to save someone's life and they're taking others. And as I described a while ago, the whole entire concept of doing that is super dangerous. Every life you change, starting far enough back, ricochets forward and dominoes into unforeseen consequences. Not to mention the dangers of what happens if someone finds an iPhone in the middle of World War II, even if you just die and it's found in a burial. But Rufus and Wyatt find one as they're confronting the bad guys on their way to go blow up the mothership. Which, again, I don't see why they'd blow it up instead of just steal it back, but either way, they need to make sure Rittenhouse doesn't have access to it. The episode was well written, it was thought out at least somewhat, and it was choreographed beautifully. All the fight scenes were good. I loved the idea of smashing a lantern onto someone's back and to light them on fire as part of the fight, he was pretty good. It was a little annoying when we had to deal with the love portion. I mean, seriously. Obviously, Lucy and Wyatt have feelings for each other. Obviously, this has been going on since, I think, the first or second episode. I'd have to go back and double check. I think I called it by the third or fourth. But now, Wyatt's all like, oh yeah, it's good that we have our team historian back. And Rufus is all like, yeah, historian. That's why we were risking our lives to save her. Later, he just directly calls him out in the Jeep. Look, you love Lucy. We just know this. And he's like, whatever. Because, you know, we need the strong, silent type to not want to admit to his feelings like he's in grade school. Meanwhile, who knows what Rittenhouse is really up to. Although I'm getting the feeling this season we're going to get more answers towards that. But before we do that, let's talk about the guest appearance of a famous scientist and pioneer, Marie Curie. Like every episode, it teaches us an interesting little bit about a historical figure. In this case, Marie Curie. Alright, so, I'll be honest, I didn't even know that she had two daughters. So, or the fact that she used the X-ray machine in World War I. I knew she invented it and that she came up with the concept of X-rays and all that stuff. Although there's also part of me that laughed when she said, oh no, it's totally safe, don't believe the stories. I'm like, no, you're dying of radiation poison already by this point in time, Miss Curie, sorry. But she was literally one of those strong women that changed history. And because of her, we have technology we have today. Her destiny laid elsewhere, though. Because, you see, Rittenhouse didn't get to kill her, thanks to Lucy. The Rittenhouse rules are pretty clear. If anyone sees the mothership, they die. And, well, Marie Curie and her daughter did. But imagine how that would change history. Again, it's one of those, people aren't even thinking these things through. I felt bad when it was Flynn, but Flynn didn't really 100% have a plan. Now that it's Rittenhouse making these mistakes, I'm like, oh, how could you possibly be so far ahead in this time travel thing if you don't understand the basics of don't mess with time unless you're sure of what the differences are going to be. Now, I did like the whole, oh, the idea is that they've been planning this for 100 years, and all they're going to do is use the time machine to alter things so that in the present they already are in control. But the unintended consequences seem so easily overdone that I can't believe that even with agents scattered throughout time, that they aren't totally going to mess up the timeline and end up invalidating their own work. And when they're all like, oh, I made sure that your sister could never come back, I'm like, yeah, sorry, Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure. Only the last person to time travel matters. But okay, so we have a team that's sitting in the bunker waiting for them to come back. We have a team that's going to the missions. And that's a good place to start for the season. But the Mexican standoff didn't make much sense. Why was his life so important? And you know what? Then it became clear. But not until after Lucy got home. Which, yay! We rescued Lucy. Much rejoicing. But alright. Then comes the real big reveal. Who he is. He was the Rittenhouse member who 100 years ago came up with the concept of if we could time travel. And with that, I just want to touch on the fact that imagination is not limited by technology. I understand that. The concept of magical or technological time travel has been around forever. So it's very reasonable that someone could sit and start to think through what would happen. The problem, of course, being how to win a time war is beyond even us now. I want you to think about what it would require, the level of thought. It would be like, did you ever see Star Trek II when they say that Khan's still thinking in two dimensions instead of three? Well, you need to think in four dimensions to win a time war. And you need to figure out cause and effect for millions of different things. But either way, they came up with this concept of sleeper cells throughout time. And I think that was actually a pretty good one. Get your people in the ground. Get them accustomed to the land, the lay of the land. If you could find a way to make those cell phones work for calls, you could even just send someone back and have them communicate with multiple sleeper cells at once. But without satellites, I don't know how they'd do that. But then we have the ending, and the fact that Flynn had already been fighting Rittenhouse. Flynn already had some concept of what they were capable of and what they knew. he might be able to give some information. And I hope he ends up going back in time a couple times. They did do a whole this season on Timeless, and it does look to be just as cool as last year. But I'm holding out a little bit farther to make sure that it's still cool. Let me know down in the comments, though. What did you think about the concept? And do you think that someone who could barely understand how radiation works could possibly come up with a plan that revolves around four dimensions? I'm curious what you think. But of course, like and share this video. And of course, if you haven't already, click that subscribe button. Because we do time travel all the time, but the only way we're going is forward. Forward to building this community as we walk through the heart of the story of Timeless. A story that teaches, but at the same time it excites, and may even have a few download spirals along the way. I hope you have a good night, and thanks for watching.